Oh well, 2020 was really a rotten year to the end. I was making my last video of the year with the 1925, and all of a sudden it made a weird noise, and then some bad smell came out and the display went on the fritz.
Hello and welcome back. If you follow the channel, you know that I recently played a lot with my HP 9825, trying to imitate Mr. Fancy Pants from the HP catalog. It gave us impeccable support while repairing the HP 98035 clocks, and endured 1,000 power-up cycles. But when I was filming my video celebrating the 100,000 subscribers milestone, it decided it had had enough, and suddenly gave up the ghost.
And the machine stopped working, of course I turned it off, and what happened is that the power supply, one of the transistors just let go, became a short, and the 5V became 13V all of a sudden, so one of the circuits, the TTL circuits, exploded actually in my clock interface. And that's what's left of the circuit that exploded in my clock interface. So I don't know if the circuit went short and blew the supply, or the supply went short and blew the circuit. And I suspect it's actually the latter, and that the power went high in the whole thing, and that this was the first circuit that took the brunt of it. And it might have zapped plenty of circuits on this poor 9825, so I don't know how catastrophic it is. So Carl is helping me taking care of the HP 9825 that has been dead since the beginning of the year, actually. And then what happens is that the power supply, a transistor let go, and if the transistor goes and shorts, it shorts basically the unregulated to the 5V, so I got 13V on my 5V. It's one of these. It's a 30A transistor, actually. So it's not an usual one, so they were pushing it. But I think once we repair that, we should have a working supply. The problem is, it got the 13V all over the place over here, so how much damage we have done, I don't know.
Depends on how quickly it went, right?
Yeah. So here you have the schematics, and it's regulated, and I believe the transistor that went down is this one. And it's an early switcher. It actually has some IC in there. And then you can see the Schottky diode. That's this big boy over here. And then there should be a coil, so that's probably this one, stores the energy. Actually, there are two, so go figure, one of those things. And the problem with that design is that if the transistor goes bad, then your high voltage is going straight through to the 5V, and it fries all your TTL, which is unfortunately what just happened.
So this power supply is just a buck converter, which I explained during a previous epic repair of a more modern HP switching power supply. That poor supply kept blowing itself up, and I wonder at the time why they made it so complicated and had first a buck converter, then followed by another DC to DC converter. And now it suddenly makes sense. It's to avoid this very failure mode, where a dead buck switching transistor would kill the whole equipment the power supply is connected to. In this more complicated modern design, my dead transistor in the buck converter just killed the DC to DC converter following it. It was still very annoying, but it stopped right there, with damage only in the power supply.
And that explains why my other supply, my other HP supply, was wondering why do they do a DC to DC converter followed by a switcher? That's stupid, right? I mean, no, it's not stupid. It protects you against that fault, right? So in the later supplies, they first bring down the voltage, and then they bring it back up with a switcher and a transformer, which means if either stage is failed, you never have a continuous feed from the unregulated to the regulated. But in this one, they didn't do it.
Yeah.
This is 4398. Must be this one, right next to the main switching transistor.
4393, right?
No, it's an 8, I think.
Is that right?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
We'll see. 1 ohm, 0 ohm. So it's a complete short. But that might... And the guy is... He's as much as short as you can get.
That makes it a great pen.
The emitter is just connected to the collector. It would be interesting actually to open it up and see how much damage there is in there. I think the transistor may have literally blown. Okay, so that's a transistor that has definitely lost its mojo. And it overheated and slid from its pad, soldering pad maybe? I think I see the former footprint to the left. It's not centered anymore. And it both fused and broke in pieces. That's no fun. Okay, not a happy transistor anymore.
So as expected, a pretty straightforward failure, the main switching transistor was just a solid short. After a quick check with the HP community, we discovered that we were not the first one with that very problem. We did the customary checks for the caps and other ancillary stuff, but all was well. So hopefully when we replace the transistor, we'll have a good supply again. But God only knows how much damage the overvoltage has done to the complicated circuitry of our beloved 9825.
Alright, so we've put the power supply back in, we've taken all the power connectors out, so it's not hopefully connected to anything. And that's a Hail Mary, because we just replaced the transistor, checked the caps quickly. Should I go on, see if we have 5 volts? We do have 5 volts, 5.1 volts. Okay, so it was a transistor. Let's test all the other voltages and then we'll just plug and see what damage we have. So Carl had a good idea to check the resistance from 5 volts to ground as we plug things in. And this board should not consume too much, that's the memory and stuff. So 69 ohms, fine. That's the main computer board, so that should suck a lot of current. It's 3.9 ohms, so there we don't know. Could be normal, could be...
1.2 amps.
It's not zero. It's not zero.
It's just watts.
And then we have to plug in the keyboard. So we connected the keyboard, so now it's everything. And it's 2.2 ohms. But 12 is 3 amps, I bet you 5 is way more than that.
Yes. Yeah.
It's a pretty power hungry processor in there.
It's
and
the
MOS.
That
right?
Big beefy transistor.
Yeah. Okay, we'll try Hail Mary, which we don't know. But...
You have 5 volts?
Okay, it's unhappy with something.
Not sure 5 volts was good there.
Well, but we fried something else. We had forgotten the data connector back to the keyboard display, so maybe that was it. Ah. No beeps, but no T. Not starting up.
Okay, our power supply was a simple fault and a quick repair. But unfortunately, and not too surprisingly, our HP9825 did not boot back up. The overvoltage has done much damage to the computer circuitry. We're still in the middle of trying to revive it, and so far it has been anything but simple. Actually, I am still not quite sure that we will be able to bring it back to life. But this is a noble and groundbreaking 16-bit machine, and you can bet that we'll try our best to save it. So hopefully, see you in the next episode.